go, you drunken reprobate.
Meniscalio.
We interrupt our regular program to bring you this news.
Problem is, I don't want to go to the gas chamber. I have headaches. I kill. I don't get them.
That is fucked up.
You want to live, don't you?
Does it ever bother you that people call you Shorty?
Does it bother you that people call you a retard?
Nobody calls me that.
Hi, friend.
You know somebody around these parts called the Crone?
Take this road for a couple of miles.
And right up yonder, the road splits. You bear right. And then you be on Old Cherry Blossom Road. And you go till you see a house.
How'd I know the house?
Ain't but one. Hey, hold up a minute, friend. Hey, come on out. I need to show you something. Well, come on out. I won't hurt you. Go on. Show him.
What the hell you do that for?
She's abnormal, a retard, but she don't complain, won't tell nobody. Back your truck for $2. She's tight.
That no more.
No, I won't ever again.
Adiós.
You stop by any time, Ariel. I'm giving out free haircuts to the members of the group.
Well, that's really sweet of you, Roger.
We gotta take care of our own, right?
Alma! Alma! Alma!
Excuse me.
Damn it, Alma, I've been looking all over for you. We got two sick kids at home and you're hanging out with these losers again.
They're not losers.
I'm telling you, we don't need these people.
You need to calm down, son. Before the hurricane, the biggest challenge I faced was whether to give somebody a crew cut or a trim. And the only person I ever thought of, the only person I even worried about, was me. And I was alone. Now, I don't remember exactly what happened the night Eve hit, but I do know that something washed that man away. Because the man you see before you now, the man who survived that night, knows his life has just begun. By coming here and meeting all of you and hearing all your stories, I've realized that the only way to truly move ahead is to do it with all of you. I'm just grateful that I'll never have to be alone again. Samantha, pick out something nice for my new clients and maybe something for... you get the gist.
Can I get you a cup of coffee, sir?
May I? Not can I, may I.
May I get you a cup of coffee, sir?
No. Order something nice for my wife, would you? Excellent sweater.
Excuse me. There's the matter of...
Right. I got it. It must be nice to have money.
No shit.
You owe me a beer.
I'll give you a cigarette.
Learn to describe lesions systematically so your superiors don't look at you all like you're complete dumbasses. How you doing, Mr. Hayslip? I'm Dr. Pratt. You mind if I take a look at you?
That's what I'm here for.
Good. All righty.
So what are they?
Let me run some tests and we'll find out for you, okay? Full lung cancer with 100 skin mets. What do you think? You have a primary care doctor?
No.
Mr. Hayslip.
Let me guess. More tests.
Actually, that won't be necessary.
Good. Give me a nice little cream for my rash and I'm out of here.
It's not a rash. Look, I don't know how to say this, so I'm just gonna come right out and say it. You've got advanced lung cancer.
What?
Which is metastasized to your skin.
These are little cancers?
You need to see oncology. They'll have the results of your biopsy and can recommend a course of chemotherapy. I'm sorry.